Welcome back, dear students. Continuing with the same chapter, in this class we are going to compare two posters. Take page 120. Look at the slide. You can see a poster with some place names and some numbers. Go through the poster. We have already learned Lorry Lane Carnival poster with the keywords to attract the reader. Is this poster written in the same way? No. This poster is more difficult to remember than the poster advertising a carnival. Now look at the poster in page 120. First column represents some places. The name of the bus is Dublin Mounir. Dublin is the capital of Ireland. The next five columns are bus timings. This bus takes five trips every day. It starts and ends in the same place, Stanford Lewis. First trip starts at 10. The bus provides transport for walkers and hikers. Ticket price is written down. Each ticket costs 5 euros. And if it is a family of 2 adults and 2 children, you have to pay only 12 euros. For more information, website is given. It is a complete poster. Children, now look at the question. Question number 1. Skim over this poster. What is it about? A bus route and a timetable. Children, the question is written on the top of the slide. Skim over this poster. What is it about? Answer: a bus route and timetable. Question number 2. What is a mountaineer? Look at the meaning in the dictionary. Answer: a climber of mountains. 3A. What does the name of the bus service suggest about the activity and the area the bus covers? Answer: the bus takes a mountain route. It transports people into the mountains for walks. Children, when you read the answer, look at the pictures given to understand the concept better. Read question B. Do you think it is a good name for this bus? Why? Answer: yes, a mountaineer climbs mountains and the bus takes people into the mountains for walks. See, which type of figurative language is used in the name Dublin Mountaineer? All of you know the answer. Personification. It compares the bus to a person. Children, look at the pictures. B. What is the purpose of the Dublin Mountaineer poster? 1. A. What is it advertising or promoting? Answer: a bus service, its route and timetable. B. Is it persuasive, informative or both? Give examples. Answer: mainly informative, gives details of the name, time and route of the service. Children, look at this slide. In this slide, we are going to compare two posters. The Dublin Mountaineer poster with the Lorry Lane Carnival poster. Read the headings: purpose, style, audience, organization and impact. The top part is Lorry Lane Carnival poster and down the Dublin Mountaineer poster. First, let us see the purpose of Lorry Lane Carnival poster. It is to persuade people to come to the carnival and gives the necessary information. The Dublin Mountaineer poster is more informative. It gives information about the bus route, but it still aims to public interest. Let us move to style. The language is relaxed, friendly, personal and persuasive. But in the second poster, the language is formal, informative and impersonal. Audience. The first poster is aimed at adults and children, but mostly to encourage children to bring their parents. The second poster is aimed at adults who need specific information in order to organize an outing. Organization. The layout is creative and fun. The second poster, the writing is set out clearly so that it is easy to understand the timetable and other details. Impact. The colorful font style of poster is eye-catching and will draw attention. The second poster is neat, clear presentation of the information is appealing to those who need to know what to do and where to go. Children, go through this slide and read it again. Children, take out page 123. B. Prepositions are useful for giving directions. You have already learned what is a preposition. A preposition is a word that comes before a noun to show how and where things are positioned. First, prepositions of time. At 11:30 a.m. on Tuesday, by lunchtime, since yesterday, all underlined words are prepositions of time. At, on, by, since. Second, prepositions of place. At the bus stop, in the bus, under the tree, through the gate. Children, look at the words underlined. At, in, under, through are the prepositions of place. Now we can see prepositional phrase. An adverbial phrase which starts with a preposition is called prepositional phrase. You can see the example. On our walk, we climbed a few hills. We followed the path up the mountain. You learned all this in the previous classes, so I don't think you need further explanation. Children, in the same page, read these directions for a recommended walk in the area. List all the prepositions and prepositional phrases you can see. Children, there is a paragraph. All the prepositions are highlighted with red color. From, towards, up, to, again from, down, into, over, through, along, to, across, back to. Children, you have to read the full sentences and understand the prepositions, and you have to underline it and write it in your notebook. Question number B. What happens if we use an incorrect preposition? The meaning will change and the directions will be incorrect. Page 124, question number 2. Complete each sentence with the correct prepositions to describe the bus route on the map. Write them in your notebook. Children, the colored words are the prepositions and the underlined words are the bus route. A. The Dublin Mountaineer heads along the road towards the first stop. Along and towards are the prepositions. B. After the Glengullen stop, it arrives at Wicklow Way. After, at are the prepositions. C. It winds its way through the forest and around the mountains. The mountains and the forest are the bus route. Through and around are the prepositions. The final trip is between Grange Road and Sandyford Lewis. Children, between is the preposition used. Homework, write all the grammar portions in your grammar notebook. Read the lesson twice. Write all the questions and answers in your notebook. Take care, children.